Greetings. Ahmed Deedat claims that the Quran is a third testament.
We Muslims, we claim that this is the last testament because it answers all your problems.
But Deedat does not understand the first two testaments. The Old Testament details the Abrahamic covenant. It was ratified with the blood of bulls and goats. The New Testament details the new covenant. It was established with the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ with his crucifixion at Calvary. Each testament documents a covenant. So what covenant does this alleged Third Testament document? It is a question Islam must answer, or the claim is false. Let's look briefly at how the New Testament relates to the Old Testament. The Old Testament is the Torah and the Psalms and the Prophets. Now the Prophets revealed God's message. The New Testament, or the Good News, is the Gospel of Jesus Christ, that He is the Son of God. And you'll find that the Bible, which is in yellow, contains the Old Testament, which is in green. It embraces the Old Covenant. The Old Covenant, the Old Testament, is the foundation of the New Covenant, the New Testament. They are intertwined. You cannot have the New Testament and the New Covenant without the Old Testament and the Old Covenant. So the New Testament completely respects the Old Testament. The New Testament does not call the Old Testament corrupted. Let's look at examples of how the New Testament respects and shows respect for the Old Testament. Matthew 1:22. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. That's a direct quote from the prophet Isaiah of the Old Testament. Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign, and the sign is this. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel, meaning God with us. So the New Testament completely respects the Old Testament, and it says that it might be fulfilled. It references exactly what was in the Old Testament. Matthew 2:15, and was there until the death of Herod, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Out of Egypt have I called my son. Matthew 2:23, and he came and dwelt in the city called Nazareth, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophets, he shall be called a Nazarene. Wow! Again, we see that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophets. This is how the New Testament refers to its foundation, which is the Old Testament. Matthew 4:14, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, You know, I've looked through the Quran, and there's not a single example of a reference in the Quran that says that it might be fulfilled which was spoken in the Old Testament, or that was spoken by Jesus. There is not a single example. Every one of these examples I'm showing you, you can go to the Old Testament, and you can find exactly the reference. The words are there. There is no corruption. The Old Testament gave the prophecy. The New Testament gives the fulfillment. The prophecies match. This is a confirmation out of the mouth of two witnesses. It is not corrupted. Matthew 8:17, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, you see, here's God saying, I sent my prophet Isaiah, to tell you this, and now I am fulfilling what I told my prophet to tell you. This is out of the mouth of two witnesses, the Old Testament and the New Testament. They bear witness together. Matthew 12:17, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying. Matthew 13:35, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, saying. Matthew 21:4, all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, saying. You may notice all of these references are only in Matthew, one of the four Gospels. I don't want this video to be an hour long, or else I would go through every single reference that's in the New Testament. Because after Jesus was crucified and resurrected, he appeared to his disciples and began to teach them out of the law, out of Moses, out of the prophets, all that was done concerning him. So when they sat down and wrote the Word of God, wrote the four Gospels documenting everything Jesus had told them, they knew Jesus had returned from the dead and now sat down and taught them everything from the prophets and the scriptures that foretold him. Do you see the pattern and the approach? Do you see the respect? The prophet is named and the quote is provided. Do you see the references are direct? Not, well, go look in your scriptures and you'll find something. It's that it might be fulfilled by the prophets, this and so, and he gives exactly the words. And you can find them there. You can look up every reference. But more importantly, see how God treated his message by his prophets. God sent his prophets with a message. Then God confirmed their message by fulfilling it. So we see that the New Testament stands heavily on knowing the Old Testament prophets. Now, let's examine how the Quran references the Old and New Covenants. The Quran is different. There's the Old Testament, the Torah, and the Psalms, and it is literally contained in the Bible. The New Testament refers back to it. The Quran, however, claims the Bible and the Torah are the Word of God, but only when it is needed. There are no direct quotes. There is not one single direct quote of a prophet from the Old Testament, or Jesus, or one of the apostles of the New Testament. In fact, the Quran contradicts both. It teaches disrespect for both. Essentially, you either believe the Quran, and where the Quran differs from either of the Old or New Testaments which God has endorsed and fulfilled, you must disrespect them. You must only obey Muhammad and only honor the Quran. This is not at all the example that God has given in the New Testament of how to respect the previous scriptures. Search the Quran for the word testament and you will not find it. The Quran does not claim it is a third testament. It is a message and nothing more. Why are the Old and New called testaments? They define covenants between God and man. The details of the covenants are in the testaments. So what is the covenant that Muhammad claims to bring? Who is the testator of the Quran? If you cannot answer these questions, then the Quran is not a testament. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.